Hello guys, welcome back to episode 36 of Only by the Regens with Liverpool. So we're ready to play Juve in the semi-final of the Champions League. Probably one of the hardest teams left. They probably are the hardest team left, to be honest. Pogba valued at 56 million. We had a little look at the squad in the end of the last episode. But it doesn't look any easier, to be honest. They're still second in the league. They're neck and neck with Sampdoria. We've in fact won the Premier League now. With three games left, which is very, very nice. Fantastic goal difference there, 72. Quite really, really impressive. We've played the two games since the last episode. We beat West Brom 2-0. Sacha Boll didn't score, unfortunately, but he managed to get a hat trick against QPR. He scored two penalties in that game, and his tally for the season is 36 in 34, 55 in 54. He's absolutely incredible, seriously. But we've got a full-strength team to play Juve in this episode, which is going to be lovely. We are going to start with Diana, though, rather than Markovic, even though Markovic has played well recently. Diana's been playing better. He's been averaging, the last five games, a 7.98, which is impressive. Just look at the front four there. 8.34, 8.38, and 8.34. Quite sublime, that. I don't think I mentioned the other games. Dortmund drew at home to Atletico. So Atletico are in a decent position here to go to the final. We have played Dortmund in the final in the past. We played them in 2017. So I don't mind either team, to be honest. It'll be a good final, but obviously we've got to beat Juventus first. So let's go and do that, hopefully. I see what formation they're playing. Yes, and assistant. So they're playing a 3-5-2. Juve obviously play the 3-5-2 in real life, but that might help us, you know, because we exploit the flanks anyway. I mean, I haven't got it turned on, but we naturally do that in our game when we pass it around. So we may have a lot of space here and here. So let's see what happens. We're going to leave everything the same because I've set that up with the tactic. And I'll make sure goals is turned on. And here we go. I want a good performance. A home win, it needs to happen, doesn't it? Come on, Diana. They've got maybe the first highlight. Perea, good defending by Boubry, wins it back. Ball. Good ball to Diana. Oh, what a finish! By the youngster, the regen, stinks it over the keeper. Who have they got in goal now, by the way? Forgot to check. I'll have to check that in a second. But it looked like he just dinked it over him. What a start. Look at that. He just actually, I think he just killed it. So who have they got in goal? Let's have a little look. Oh, they've got Mingele, of course. How could I forget? Hilarious. Right, can we build on this? Coutinho! Oh, it's 2-0 inside 12 minutes, and I was not expecting it to be this comfortable. I'm really surprised. What a free kick by Coutinho, though. He's got another free kick, and he scored another free kick 2 minutes later! What the actual fuck is going on? It's 3-0, and that's why we saw Mingley. He's helping us get through to the final here. We don't want to concede that away goal. Good save by Gene. He hasn't conceded in the last two games, which is decent. Lorenzini. Sterling! It's 3-0 inside 19 minutes. 27th goal of the season for Sterling. It's 4-0, sorry. Of course. I don't know what's happening. This is going too well. Coutinho with his blooming set pieces. Sterling. Coutinho again. I want Boll to score. We've still got to defend, though. Can't let it go to our heads. Come on, Villa. Sterling, he's through again. Boll. Diana. Oh my god, it's 5-0. Inside 31 minutes. This is a team. I mean, you looked at the squad. They're fucking amazing. But that formation, that 3-5-2. It looks dreadful. What is Mingele doing? He's having a shocker. Oh, they got a chance with a long throw. Oh, he's at the crossbar. But 5-0 at this stage. I don't know what's going on. Oh, speechless. We still need to defend, though. Come on, get them on the counter attack. Oh, poor ball by Sterling for once. He could have played in Diana there, Flanagan. I don't know why he chose to go back to the keeper even. Sterling. Sterling. Oh, it's the side netting. This is unbelievable. So we actually go in at the half time in the first leg of the Champions League semi-final, 5-0 up. And look at the average ratings. What do I even? They didn't even react. They're like, yeah, we'll do it. We'll just carry on with doing what we're doing. And they haven't even changed formation. This is ridiculous. Okay, we'll just carry on. I'm going to encourage them, you know. Yeah, come on, keep going. Keep doing what you're doing. Bubba's picked up a slight knock. But their morale surely has to be crushed now. We still don't want to concede that away goal. Oh, good defending. Oh, Vidal's won it back though. Come on, surround him. Song, is that Alex Song? Oh, and he just blazes it over. So we haven't been as good in the second half. But when you score 5 goals in the first half, how do you top that? Yeah, we'll bring on Moreno and conserve a bit of energy here. Maybe we get a few. I kind of don't want to bring off Coutinho because he's on a hat trick. I mean, we have been clinical. What the hell? What the hell? Can we get a sixth? Ball. Oh, off the line. Moreno scored. We're winning 6-0. What the fuck? Oh my days. We're winning 6-0 and Ball hasn't even scored. That's. Oh my, this team is just ridiculous. Sterling. Ball. Oh, I thought he was going to make it 7. Are they going to get an away goal? Villa's been a tank, hasn't he? Look at that, 6-0. In the Champions League semi-final first leg. What the fuck? No one's even asked. They're just like, yeah, job done. Oh, that is bizarre. That has to be one of. I'm so glad I recorded this game because that's got to be one of most, like, surprising results. I mean, look at their team, man. We just beat them 6-0. Oh, that's so bizarre. I'm also scouting this guy. He can play right back. He's quite versatile. He can play centre mid. He looks very, very good. His marking, his passing, it's what I like. So, I've put in a bid. It's got accepted, and hopefully his work permit gets accepted as well. But I don't know. We're pretty much through to the final again, aren't we? Because 6-0. Holy shit! Obviously, I'll play the Swansea game off camera and I'll come back for the Juventus game. So hopefully it's as exciting as that one. Jesus Christ, I'll see you then. Okay, so we're ready to play Juve in the second leg. So I don't know how we can improve on winning 6-0. It's not going to happen. But we're going to try the 4-3-3 formation for this one and see how that works. Because it gives me some time to experiment in a way. Because I can't see Juve scoring 7 goals or even 6 goals against us. If they did, I mean, I'd be very fucking surprised, but I was surprised to beat them 6-0 anyway. We did play Swansea. Disappointing draw, actually. I don't really know how we drew this game. We dominated completely, but we just couldn't score. So that's 2 games in a row without Sacha Boel scoring. Oh my God. The world's coming to an end. But who knows? Who knows what's going to happen in this game? We are going to play Markovic for this game. Diana's been unsettled by PSG. And I don't really know why, but it's just one of those things, isn't it? So he's going to be on the bench for this one, and yeah, it's going to be a full-strength team other than that. So we're going to go straight into the game, and then obviously we'll check out what happens in the next tie, the Dortmund Atletico second leg as well. But this should be pretty straightforward, hopefully. So they've changed to a 4-2-2-2, the same exact same formation that Benfica played actually. Let's see what's going to go on here. Yeah, we don't have to address anything, that's fine. and let's see what happens. It should be a comfortable win, I hope. Markovic, come on. Coutinho, can we get a good start? Not as confident with this formation, as I've said in the past, but, you know, it's still okay. Villa. Oh, it's a terrible header to Tevez, and we got away with that one. Come on, ball. Lorenzini. Coutinho. Flanagan. Coutinho. Markovic. Is he onside? Oh my days. It's 7-0 on aggregate. And we've got the away goal as well. They now have to score 8. And that's not happening. That's not happening, is it? What a parry by Mingele. You'll be happy with that one. But Juve definitely creating more chances with this 4-2-2-2. Being a bit more of an even game. Buba. Sterling. Lorenzini. Buba passing it around nicely. And Yanis eyes give away a penalty. Can Bol score a penalty? Can he finally score his first in 3 games? Yes, he does. 2-0, 8-0 on aggregate. And it just goes from bad to worse for Juventus, but this is just fantastic. I mean, I've never seen a Champions League semi-final be so one-sided. I don't think we're done, you know. Markovic. Coutinho. Sar. Sterling. Oh, and Mingley manages to save that one. Sterling again, though. Sar. Buba playing right back. He's gone over there. We are having a lot of chances. Ball, Markovic, Villa, and Sacco puts it in, and it's 3-0. And this is unbelievable, you know, because this is Juventus. And for some reason, we are just destroying them. At the moment. I mean, 9-0 on aggregate in the semi-final. Who knows what this is gonna finish. Wonder what their morale is like. It's got to be abysmal at this stage. Are they actually going to score? They're passing it sideways. We might have a chance with Berardi. And he just can't score. They're bound to get one, surely. Gene. They have a few highlights here. We've defended well. Over both legs, we've defended well. And Yanazai finally scores a goal for them. So it's 9-1 on aggregate. And this game has been a lot more even, but obviously we've taken our chances so far. But I still can't believe we're destroying Juventus. Yeah, we are happy about that. And it's not the most effective formation, ours, is it? I mean, obviously it is Juventus, and they are one of the best teams in the game at the moment. But I'm still considering switching to the home tactic and see what we can do in the second half. But I think we'll just leave it the same for now. Expect Juve to just pile everything on us. I may just switch it to counter and see if we can get a couple more goals on the break. I don't know. But we'll tell the team to concentrate. Everyone seems fit at the moment. Got Ball, Flanagan, Markovic. Ball, oh, that's a fantastic goal. That seriously is a brilliant goal by Sacha Ball. Nice passing football there. No one tracks him. And there we go, he gets his second goal of the game. 10-1 on aggregate. I'm going to bring off Flanagan for Wisdom. And that's about it, I think, for now. Are Juventus going to have another goal? They're going to make it 4-2? Haven't really seen much of Pogba, have we, over the two legs? He's been sawed. And they miss another good chance there. Could have been closer this game. Markovic has to go off injured. Where's our right back? Is that Wisdom? That Kingsley Coleman has just missed so many chances since coming on. Coutinho, Buba, Lorenzini. Ah, Pogba wins it. Trying to track him. Oh, it's Coleman, not Coleman. My bad. Buba. Try and find Ball. Oh, I want Ball to get his hat trick. There we have it. We're through to the Champions League final, and that's got to be one of the most exceptional semi-finals I've ever been involved in. What? I mean, to win 6-0 at home is something, but then to go and beat them 4-1 in Italy is again just fantastic. So when's the next game? It's actually tomorrow in game terms. So nice 3.92 million there. And what's Ball on for the overall? 57 and 57. Hope he gets to 60. That would be just brilliant. Right, so we'll see who we actually get put up against in the Champions League final. Will it be Dortmund? Will it be Atletico? Creates new record, 9 assists, and he breaks his own record. That is just sweet. Is it game time? Has it happened? Oh my God! Atletico won 5-1 at home. Mandzukic got a hat trick, and this guy, a regen who looks pretty good. He looks very good. He got two. Actually, I have a little scout report on him. So it looks like we're against Atletico, and Atletico dominated them. Let's have a look at the team. So they got Koke, Correa, obviously Griezmann, Wanyama. So they got some good players, but I'd still say Juventus has a better squad overall. But who knows? They're currently fourth in La Liga. And we've beat Real Madrid this season. We've beat Barcelona this season. So I'm hoping we can beat Atletico. But we only get one chance of it, of course. But I'm going to be back then. It's 8 for the 6, so it's quite a long way away, actually. It's quite late into June. Well, yeah, you kind of expect the season to end in May, don't you? But I'll be back for the Champions League final, guys. Hope you've enjoyed it. It's been quite a sensational episode for goals. But I'll see you then. Bye bye.